Good morning, and today I am going to take interview with a gentleman called Kamal Babbar. And Kamal Babbar is a financial planner. He's a very, very professional financial planner and serving more than 1,000 clients since 18 years. So Kamal, thank you very much for your time. And I really welcome you in my show. And I'm going to ask you some questions about your life, your business, your philosophy, and how you got benefit by association with me and utilizing my services as a mentor and using my system called Sales Cast Sequencer system. So Kamal, really welcome on my show.
Thank you.
I know you are a very cool and calm person, so you speak very, very selected word. Yeah. So Kamal, tell me a little bit about yourself, your life. How do you started your journey? Because everybody wants to know successful people journey and their struggle. How did you came on this financial planning
course? Just by luck, by chance. It was not predestined. It was not planned. I am basically belong to a very middle class family. And after passing my 12th, I just joined DSA, Direct Sale Associate of a bank, for opening the saving bank and current bank account. And doing that old convincing activity, I supposed to met a retired LIC development officer, and he introduced me to the financial industry. And since then, the journey is on, it is keep going on. I'm enjoying a very beautiful trip. And I have made a mission out of it that I want to make people achieve their goal of financial security. And this has become my commitment to myself, to my clients. And it's been almost more than 18 plus years of success and serving more than 1,500 plus satisfied clients. So it's a great journey. It's a great journey.
Wow, really awesome. You talk about it's a journey and you are on a mission, because very few people are in a mission right now. If you see, most people, they are like focusing on only selling. But very rare are few people who are in the mission. And I think that would be one of your reasons to be successful in this financial planning domain, Kamal.
Yeah, well, see, everyone, be it you or me or anyone else, so everyone basically wants to do the change in the society, and depend on the degree, at what degree you carry that passion, that commitment, and more you are, have a clarity on your mission, the more passionate you become about achieving your goal. And you basically, your goal is not your goal, basically it becomes everybody's goal. So more and more people join you, and it's become a automatic a mission. And mission is such a powerful words, and no doubt monetary benefits are always there, but more than money is something else that cannot be expressed in words, right? So I think when you have a passion, when you have a clarity, when you are focused on your goal, then everyone else join you. They love to join you, right? So I am feeling right now, I am feeling that momentum is going on and people are joining me in my mission.
That's wonderful. But Kamal, when you associated with me, you are an MDRT qualifier as a life insurance advisor, yeah? And 2.5 years back, then you qualified COT, which means you multiply your income and business 3 times. That time, do you have that kind of clarity in your life, vision, mission, and you had that kind of... So what really helped you to achieve you multiply your business 3 times, your income and mission, and totally transform the game? So talk about that.
In every domain, there are 2 types of things. One is the self-motivation, and there is a external motivation, right? So self-motivated people are very exceptional. I am not self-motivated guy. So motivation comes and goes, right? It's a regular bath. Sometimes you forget to take a bath, right? So you need someone who can forcefully let you know the bath, right? So coach is someone who always stand with you, guide you, and he let you explore yourself, right? So it's been almost more than 2.5 years that we have started working together. It's a collaboration. And collaboration has been very fruitful till now for you and for me also. And so there is no doubt positive change. And you as a coach has definitely been a ringing bell. So whenever I go to the sleeping mode, you always wake me up. Right. So I'm enjoying. So I love to sleep. Right. I love relaxing. I love go to comfort zone. So I think about high thoughts about me. Yes, I have done most of the things. So I become very complacent. So you as a coach, wake me up, guide me, run with me. And the best part of a coach like you, becomes very important when the role becomes very critical when you walk the talk, when you run with your coachee, right? So that's why I do recommend that most of the financial advisor should have a coach, should have a mentor. When someone is running with you, right? Your enthusiasm, your level of passion goes up, right? Yeah. So that's the beauty of having a coach in your professional life.
Rightly said, Kamal, and you talk about the complacency and comfort zone. So yes, as a mentor, I help you and I push you also many times. Talk about the experience in a month when the month of March, when you COT qualify, you did a business of, I think, 33 lakh rupees in a single month.
Yes.
How that happened? What was the one point which changed the whole game? Because people who are watching this interview, they want to learn also. They want to apply that in their business and life.
It's all about clarity. It's all about passion. And the best part is you must know your goal, right? If you know your goal, that gives you that becomes an antibiotic to your something that you cannot express, right? So basically, clarity about your goal is something that motivated me, encouraged me to get that kind of business in a month.
All right. So, जब आपने business start किया था या जब आप MDRT हो गए थे और आप बीच में कुछ off track भी हुए थे, so talk about the challenges which you faced in your career, in your business, in your life. What were the challenges जो आपने face किए? And how do you overcome them?
It's been almost more than 18 years. I've been qualifying for MDRT since last 10 years, right? So qualifying MDRT is a great achievement. But being there for many years and there is no any escalation, there is no any growth in that situation, that even water becomes adulterated, unpure, right? So it's been more than 2.5 years with your coaching, guidance, mentorship. I implemented ideas and I stick to those ideas. I'm not a good student, right? I'm not a good learner. So whatever I could do in these 2.5 years, that has really instilled some benefits in my professional as well as my personal life. And there are a lot of challenges like complacency, challenges about procrastination, right? Challenges about lack of confidence, lack of clarity, having no goal. These were some of the challenges that I was facing.
So you overcame them, and I push you sometime a lot, and I'm a hard coach sometime, and yes, I do remember. But at the end of the day, if you win, then it's worth it. Yeah?
Yes.
So, tell me, Kamal, if anybody, there are a lot of students, there are a lot of people who are watching this interview, there are a lot of people who want to make their career in the financial planning domain. What is your advice for them if they want to be successful in terms of integrity? Because I know you are very, very strict about integrity and honesty and many factors which people don't focus on it. So what is your advice in terms of those intangible principle which you believe a lot, if anybody want to be a lifelong successful in your domain called financial planning industry? Talk about that.
So I'm not very experienced where I can dictate someone to join the financial industry. So basically, there is a one famous book called Ikigai, right? So
yeah.
What you love to do, right? What is your passion? And what the second is, third I think parameter is people must love it, right? That is your passion and you love to do it, and how you can make that passion that people start loving it also.
Correct. And this should be you. Yes.
So yeah, I think if we add these three parameters and someone qualifies himself, yes, financial industry is something that I want to change people's perception about financial planning. It is not very difficult. It's basically more of a discipline and very simple. And under financial advisor, the journey becomes very, very simple and sober and committed. As I am a financial advisor, I'm taking your services, right? So I'm stick to my discipline. I'm stick to my commitment. So whenever, as a financial advisor, I meet someone who takes my services, and he remains committed and disciplined to his financial plan, so the probability of reaching his goal is much more than by managing his own funds. No doubt there are some exceptional, fantastic people who can and has a potential to manage their own funds. But there are a lot of people, by and large, who need financial advisors, who need financial planning, who need financial awareness. So I think especially our industry, financial planning industry, need more and more financial enthusiasts and passionate people who can come and join this industry and can make a positive impact in this industry, in the life of people.
Also, Kamal, tell me, aapki financial planning industry, when it comes to selling life insurance policies, there's a lot of manipulation happening in the marketplace. What do you say about it?
How can we stop? Nobody wants to make any miscommitment, right? Unintentionally or intentionally. But I would say a proper training can do a justice of this, right? Can mitigate this malpractices. So if a person who is new to this industry is like a clay, right? In whatever mode you can mold him. So if he or she is given a proper training about the holistic approach of financial planning, about what is sales and what is not sales, what is all about customer-centric need analysis. So I think 90% would be a proper training about a core of a financial planning, right? It should not be a sale. No doubt, sale is an integral part of any financial planning. That is a separate part. But in training, it must be taught why financial planning is a holistic approach, right? If we do a proper training of any person who joined this great industry, this financial industry, can be a great financial advisor years to come.
Okay. And what is your intake when this comes to AMCs? A lot of mutual fund companies, they are reducing the like pay part for the financial planner, and the income challenges are coming in the marketplace. And people are in India, people are not willing to pay financial planner fees. So how what do you think about it? What change we should make in the industry to ensure the fraternity of financial planner grow? And because the people are, you know, helping people to make a right decision for the money, but they also deserve a financial prosperity in their life. What is your intake about it?
So what is my intake? It's like a family. Financial industry where a father, financial industry is like a father. Mutual fund is one son and life insurance is second son.
Correct.
If in a family, two brothers remains harmoniously, the financial industry will boom. And one brother or second brother start struggling or quarreling with each other, start fighting with each other, the financial industry cannot go ahead. So one brother, financial solution, life insurance industry, and second brother, mutual fund, should complement each other, right? One cannot keep the 100% space of second one, right? So each one of them should work together, complement each other, right? If my client need mutual fund, definitely I should refer mutual fund. If mutual fund advisors, clients need life insurance product, a mutual fund advisor should or must advise him life insurance product. So it's basically a harmonious bonding that should go hand in hand.
So you are talking about the cooperation, right? We should complement each other, support each other, rather than fighting with each other. Because in market, mein media and they always, you know, they talk about mutual fund guy talk about life insurance guy talk about mutual fund. Some people sell both the products, so they try to sell life insurance because there is a huge money over there. But as you rightly said, as a financial planner, your job is to make people safe, secure their money. So one line, how do you define financial planner? What is the most important job of a financial planner?
See, financial planning is all about making someone realize what are their financial goals. One, how and when they are going to achieve those goals. And what they need, how they can reach there. So financial planner role is to make that journey realistic and practical and disciplined for them.
Okay. So you as a financial planner, your job is not to sell, is to tell people right thing, make them, help them to make a right decision for themselves. Automatically your sale will happen. Is that correct?
Yeah. It is a result of, financial advisor, selling is a byproduct, right? Automatically it will come. So if you are true, if you are sincere, if you are committed to your goal, to your vision, definitely you will get a lot of sale that you cannot even manage that, right? So you have to be very holistic in your approach.
Okay. So lastly, I want to ask you the question. Give your three secrets of your success. You are a corporate club membership with LIC of India. You are also managing good amount of mutual fund AMC. You have a good business. You have employees also. So your three secrets which got you here. What are those three secrets?
One is there are a lot of things. One I would choose is your passion. Okay. I love my work, right? So it is my ikigai, right? So this is something that that keeps me going. And I'm a very not a social person, but this industry has really evolved me, right? So one is the passion, right? I love this industry. Second is the integrity, right? Integrity plays a very important role. And when you have respect, when you have trustworthiness in the industry, along with the competency, right? And people will love you literally. Third is, I would suggest training. Spend a lot on your self-training, read a lot of books, watch a lot of useful videos, maybe a TED Talks, many other platforms. And I would suggest also, it is also recommendable that to have a coach also.
Okay.
Right. These three things, I personally believe, have helped me really well.
Okay, Kamal, that's wonderful. Thank you so much for your time. Now, I want to ask you, if anybody want to take your services, so how people can contact you, where they should go, how they can call you, where they can email you. So if you provide, then I will put the link on the description and they will definitely be able to talk to you and they will take your services. Yeah. And lastly, Kamal, one thing. As I told you, I offer two services. One is one-on-one consulting, which you take from me. And second, there are a lot of people who have money challenge right now, they want to learn from me online. So I got two things. One is Sales Ka Chukandar system and one is one-on-one mentoring session with me. Yeah. So in both of them, what do you recommend people? If anybody want to grow, you talk about have to have coach as a mentor. Second, I have a Sales Ka Chukandar system. So according to you, what is the best way to start people who want to take my services?
I would suggest that you are trying to contribute a lot toward the society, toward the financial industry as a coach, right? I would say you are playing a role of a change maker, and you have made a lot of videos, right? You have a YouTube channel, so people can subscribe your channel and can learn a lot of things about the financial industry. One, this is one of the easiest way to avail your services. Second would be, you have written a wonderful book called Sales Ka Sikandar.
Yeah, this is.
Yeah, so people, you have written it in a very crisp and a very simple manner, right? So people can go through and have a look about this book. And third would be having a one-to-one sessions. And it would be totally a person's call, how he wants to go with that. Otherwise, these are the things that people can avail your services.
All right, Kamal. So thank you very much for your time. And lastly, you want to add anything, any message you want to give for people who want to make money in this industry, or any message for your customer, anything you want to say, because we are at the end of this discussion.
The first mantra is a goal, right? Everything start with a goal, right? Mm-hmm. Even universe has started from a zero. Universe must have a goal, right? Everything has a goal. Everything has a purpose. So we must have a meaningful life. So as a professional, when we say we are a profession, there must be a reason behind it. What is my why? W-H-Y for remaining in this industry. I'm not here to time pass. I'm not here to ruin my life as well as my client's life. I'm here to make a change, a positive change in the life of my clients. So know your why and stick to it.
Wow, really, really great. Awesome, Kamal, that if you know your why, if your why is strong, you'll find a way. Yeah? So everything starts with a why.
Yes.
In fact, I just made a video 3 or 4 days back on YouTube. You can find it out. Why you should have a strong why in life. Okay. So all right, Kamal, thank you very much. And I would say all the best. You are an awesome man. And I'm really working with you right now and looking forward to take you to your next goal, and we'll rock together. Thank you very much. All the best. See you.
Same to you.